Now, once we determine, folks, that there is a relationship between two variables, we still want to come up with the equation of that line, the y equals a plus b times x. One way that we can do that, kind of a quick and dirty little way, is what is known as the high-low method. And the objective, again, is to calculate the equation of the mixed cost, that y equals a plus b times x, okay? Now, I've learned that the best way to teach high-low method is actually just to do an example. So we're going to do an example here, all right? Okay, here is a series of months and the units produced and the total cost for each. And let's say we feel that this is a situation that is a mixed cost. And we did that perhaps by plotting out a scatter diagram. Okay, the first thing that we want to do here is identify which of these columns is the x variable and which one of these is the y variable. Okay, well, which is the x variable? Units produced. Okay, and total cost is the y variable. Okay, now what we do, come off that if you would and show me, is once we've identified the x and the y, there we go, almost show it all if you can. Then what we want to do actually is we kind of want to cover up the y's. Don't even look at them. Just look at your x's, and I want you to determine which of these is the highest x and which of these is the lowest x. I'm not asking you that which is the highest y and lowest y. No. Cover up the y's so you're not even tempted to look at them right now. Which of these is the highest x? Which of these is the lowest x? Okay? So going back to the computer, once you do that, which is the highest x?
February.
Okay? That's the high. Which of these is the lowest x?
June.
That is the low. You with me? Okay? So what we're going to do then, once we've determined the high month and the low month, we're going to actually use all the data from those months now. And we are going to figure out the equation of the mixed cost. Okay? The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to determine the variable cost. Okay? So let me go back over to the document camera. All right. Okay. The first thing we're going to solve for is B, which is the variable cost. Well, that equals the change in Y over the change in X of the high and the low point. Okay? So the change in Y is it 29,000 minus 20,500. Mm-hmm. Somebody help me. Oops, I just wrote on that.
That's right.
Okay. Divided by the change in X of the high and the low point. So that would be 67,500 units minus 17,500 units. Is that correct?
Yep.
So if you compute that out, that comes out to 17 cents a unit. That is the B in our line. Are you with me? Okay. Now the next step is we want to solve for A, which is our fixed cost. The way we're going to do that is we're going to once again consider the entire equation of a mixed cost. We just solved for B. Okay? Now what we're going to do is we're going to borrow the y and the x from either the high or the low point. Okay? From the high or the low point. So going back to the computer, we're going to use either this x and y up here or this one down here. Either way, it'll give us the same answer. I usually use the low one because it seems like it's sometimes easier math. Okay? So, what is the Y? What is Y at the low point?
20,500.
20,500. A is what we're trying to solve for. What is X at the low?
17,500.
17,500. Is that correct? Okay. So once you do that, you get 20,500 equals A plus, let's see what, 0.17 times 17,500 equals, I think that's 29,75.
You can barely see it.
Thank you. So 20,500 equals A plus 29,75. So what does A equal? 17,525? Okay. So we now have our B, and we now have our A. Okay? Now, let me show you how I don't like you to show this answer. Some students will write this out. They'll say, Y equals 17,525 plus 17x. Well, yeah, sort of. But let's go ahead and define these variables times for this specific situation. What does y in this situation equal? Well, looking back at the computer, y equals total costs, right? So let's say total costs equals $17,525 plus, well, what does X equal in this example? Units produced, right? So let's say 17 cents per unit produced times the number of units produced. Now, doesn't that just give you a better warm fuzzy in your tummy that you really understand what this, what we really did was? Okay? Because now what can we do? Well, now what we can do is once we have that equation right there, let's say we expect an activity level of 20,000 units. Well, what would we expect to be our total costs? Well, we can plug it into that equation and we come up with an answer of 20,925. Are you with me? Okay? That's why we want that equation. So as managers,
if we plan and control our business, we can try to reduce costs.
Reducing costs is a huge part of running a business. Are you with me?